905, license plate Mary Nora Lincoln 731. Hey, multicolored VW Beetle with junk all over it.
Since I created my car, I have gotten at least 50 tickets. In my hometown, I have been pulled over by every cop on the force. And I get such weird tickets, like carrying an unsafe load, impeding the flow of traffic, and for having a burnt out light above my license plate. A simple trip to the supermarket can be a tremendous ordeal. There's almost always someone waiting at my car with a whole list of questions.
How long did it take you to make this? How fast can you go with this before everything starts falling off of it?
You do a lot of acid?
What first inspired you to do it?
What's the purpose behind the car?
Why do you got all this stuff on it?
When people ask me questions like this, I just say whatever comes to my mind. But the truth is, I don't know why I drive this car. I wonder why other people drive their cars. I don't know who made the first art car, but it sure seems like a lot of them came out of the 60s. You jump in front of my car when you know all the time. 90 miles an hour, girl, is the speed I drive. You tell me it's all right. You don't mind a little pain. You say you just want me to take you for a drive. You're just like, oh, stop, say, get through you.
In this bus, I conceived my third child, Sunday Peaches. This bus meant a lot to me and still means a lot to me. Obviously, I've kept it up all this time because it is like a womb to me, and it reminds me of those days in the 60s when I had such a good time and there were so many people that were part of the we generation. And that feeling is important to me, so I keep the bus, I keep it in good shape, and I come in here a lot and travel around. I go downtown, people come aboard and we talk about the 60s, and I show them my book flashing on the 60s. And it's become part of my life. I'm known for this bus now. It's part of me, Lisa Law and her hippie psychedelic bus.
Yeah, the bus springs out of the 60s, but it's not in the 60s, and it's not about nostalgia. Reporters will come and ask you questions about it. They'll want some kind of sound bite that will contain it all. The point of it is you can't contain it. It's an experience in sound and movement and joy. And it can only be expressed in this form, and it can only be experienced in this form.
My God, we still got 10 minutes before blast off. Can I offer you guys the acids and the oranges?
My approach to the automobile is just to fight it. You know, when I make a car, I redesign it using materials. I reach for anything that's next to my hand goes onto the car. If there's a dead rat, I'll grab it and glue it on the car. If there's a tin can. A piece of plastic is natural to me and a part of our planet as a rock is. And we have to You know, we have to stop the idea of hating one object over another, you know, because that's what perpetuates the junk process, the plastic process, the waste of our society is that people think, well, this is disposable. Nothing's disposable. We don't throw rocks away, and we shouldn't throw plastic away.
I shoot environmental videos, and what I do with video with this van is I try to break through into people's consciousness for a little while to get them to consider the fact that they are mammals, that they live in ecosystems, and that the ecosystems they live in are in trouble. I'm really concerned that we're going to see horrific extinctions and droughts and all kinds of disasters that people are not going to be prepared for if we don't start working right now.
Obviously started off as a pun because of the motorcycles called Kawasaki's, and I wanted to stay on the street again. I like art on the street, and it was a natural pun, so here it is, Kawasaki. I've had it up to about probably 80, something like that, 80 miles an hour. The road wasn't real flat. I think on a flat road it would easily go 100. And then the ultimate goal is to go to India.
Why India?
Well, the cow is considered sacred in India, and it seemed like if nothing else it would be worth a videotape just to see what sort of reactions we got. It seemed like a natural place to go.
In case you're wondering, my car is called Oh My God, because that's what people say when they see it for the first time. Well, I gotta go now. I'll see you on the road.
My car never tires and neither do I. When I need to go, it always flies. Sometimes I think it could steer itself when I'm going through those gears for my mental health. When it whacks down and to the side and I let it wind out, we could be in fight. The wind rushing by, the windows wide open, this car is my ship and the road is my ocean. I get a strange feeling of being uplifted, disoriented like someone too gifted. Grab onto the stick and I think as I shift, this ain't just a ride, it's something religious. I'm so fast and you're so slow, only my car knows what speed to go. When I put my foot down it accelerates, and it never calls to break a date. Just a ride, it's something religious. Me and my car, we haven't gone far. One of these days we'll go all the way. We'll cover the ground that I need to cover. Me and my car.
riding in the car, car, take me riding in the car, car, take you riding in my car, car, I'll take you riding in my car. Click, clank, open up a door, girls, click, clank, open up a door, boys, front door, back door, clickety, clack, take you riding in my car. Climb, climb, rattle on the front seat, spree I spraddle on the back seat, turn my key, step on the starter, take you riding in my car. Engine, it goes, engine, it goes, front seat, back seat, boys and girls, take you riding in my car. Trees in the houses walk along, trees in the houses walk along, truck in a cart and a garbage can, I'll take you riding in my car. Ships and little boats chug along, ships and little boats chug along, take you riding in my car. I'm gonna zoom you home again, I'm gonna zoom you home again, roll home, take you riding in my car. I'm gonna let you blow the horn, I'm gonna let you blow the horn, well, I'll take you riding in my car.